one thing she said that I 100% agreed with was on the English piece, I'm still kind of in choir mode and not in solo mode, so my piano is a choir piano, not a solo piano. I agree with that. But everything else was kind of like a, like subjective, stylistic things that me and Matt just don't agree with. She wanted me to take both of my pieces way, way slower, and they're already slow.
What are you singing?
I'm singing What Shall I Do to Show Her How Much I Love Her by Henry Purcell. And Oh, That Would Be a Mental Bed by Lou Matthew.
Oh, okay.
It's already a slow song. She was... She just wanted me to take some... On Oh, That Would Be a Mental Bed, it wasn't so bad. She just wanted me to take some extra breaths, which I have room for anyway. She wanted me and Lisa to like stretch out a lot of specific segments, and they were already going pretty slow. So a lot of it was just that, like she didn't say anything about my tone. She didn't say anything about my mouth shapes or breath support or anything. It was all stylistic. And the one score that she bogged me on was expression, because I wasn't going as slow as she wanted me to. And she wanted me to go really, really slow.
Yeah,
it's the same one we sang last night.
Yeah. We enter into a holy place through the new and living way Jesus Christ has opened up for us. We come as a holy people, born of the grace of Jesus Christ, delivered through his blood. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all those whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and on earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
On the feast day of the Passover week, when evening drew near, Jesus went to sit with his 12 disciples for the Passover meal. During the meal, he said to them, "One of you will betray me." The disciples were grieved and saddened by this announcement, and deeply concerned, each of them asked, "Lord, is it I?" He replied, "The betrayer is dipping his hand in the dish at the same time as me. The Son of Man is fulfilling the scriptures written about him. But woe to that man through whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better if he had never been born." Then Judas, the man who had betrayed him, said, "Master, is it I?" At the end of the feast, Jesus humbly came to each of his disciples and bathed their feet, wiping the dust away with a towel. Judas immediately left, and the disciples wondered if he might have been sent on an errand, since he was the group's treasurer. Then Jesus said to them, "All of you will stumble this dark night. It has been written that the shepherd will be smitten and the sheep of the flock scattered about. But morning will come, and after I am raised up, I will go before you into Galilee." But Peter said, "Even though all men will stumble, I will never be caused to stumble." And Jesus replied, "Truly, Peter, tonight, before the rooster crows, you will deny me not once, not twice, but three times." Peter said, "Even if it causes me death, I would not deny you, Lord." And the other disciples agreed with Peter that they would follow Jesus even to their own deaths. After dinner, Jesus took his disciples to the Garden of Gethsemane. He told the rest of them to sit and pray while he walked a little further into the garden with Peter, James, and John. He became distressed, knowing the agony he would be facing in the coming hours. He told his friends, "My soul is grieving. Stay with me and keep watch while I pray." He fell forward on the ground, crying out in anguish to his Father, "If it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not as I will, Father, but as you will." Sorrowful, he returned to his friends, but they had fallen asleep on the ground. Heartbroken, he asked them, "Could you not watch with me for even 1 hour? Watch and pray. You will be severely tempted, and I know your spirit is willing, but your flesh is weak." A second time, he ventured further into the garden alone and prayed, "Father, if it is not possible that this cup of suffering might pass from me, I pray that if I drink it, that your will may be done." A few days before the Passover celebration, Judas Iscariot, one of Jesus' disciples, had gone to the chief priests and asked them what they would give him if he delivered Jesus to them. The priests and elders had been conspiring with the Roman government to arrest and kill Jesus quietly so as to avoid a revolt among the Jewish people. Then they agreed to give Judas 30 pieces of silver. And from that day on, Judas had been looking for an opportunity to betray Jesus to his enemies. As Jesus continued to pray and encourage his disciples, a great crowd of people, led by Judas, came to the Garden of Gethsemane. Judas drew near to Jesus and kissed him fervently, which was the sign agreed upon by the chief priest to identify Jesus. Calmly, Jesus asked, "Friend, why are you here? Would you betray me with a kiss?" The disciples were confused and afraid and asked Jesus if they should fight the high priest's servants with their swords. And Jesus answered them, Do you not believe that I could ask my Father in heaven and legions of angels would come to my rescue? Then Jesus looked around at the crowd of chief priests, elders, and captains of the temple. He asked them, "Why do you come to me with weapons as if I were a thief? Every day I have been with you in the temple, and you did not lay a hand on me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness. All this has come to pass so that the words of the prophets might be fulfilled." Then the disciples fled in fear, forsaking Jesus, and the angry mob seized him and led him away.
Amen.
The priests and elders delivered Jesus bound tightly to Pontius Pilate. Pilate had Jesus beaten, thinking this punishment would appease the Jewish rulers. As Jesus stood before the governor, Pilate questioned him, but he remained silent. The soldiers braided a crown of thorns and placed it on his head and put a purple robe over his shoulders, mocking him. Pilate went out to the people, saying, "I find no fault in him." Then he brought Jesus out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. "Behold the man," Pilate said. And the people cried out,
"Crucify him!"
Once again, Pilate questioned Jesus, and he gave no answer. Pilate asked him, "Don't you understand that I have the power to kill you or set you free?" Jesus answered, "You would have no power at all except God gave it to you." And once again, Pilate brought Jesus to the people and said, "Behold your king." But they cried out,
"Crucify him!"
Pilate washed his hands and said, "I am innocent of the blood of this righteous man." The angry mob cried out,
"Let his blood be on us and on our children."
So Pilate handed Jesus over to them to be crucified.
Thank you.
Who has believed our report, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up like a tender plant, like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or loveliness when we beheld him. There was no beauty that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected. He was a man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, and we wanted to hide our faces from him. Surely he has borne our griefs. He has carried our sorrows, but we considered him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities, and the punishment for our guilt was laid upon him, and by his stripes we are healed.
Oh, say, Redhead,
crucified, my Lord. Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when thus pierced him in the side? Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you Sometimes it causes me to tremble.